It's time for another dose of classic muscle. Time to drop by Nick's Garage. Joel has got his head under the hood of this beautiful Fury convertible, changing the fuel pump.
And here we go! What a beautiful day to drive my convertible. We're in a 1970 Plymouth Fury convertible with a 318 V8 automatic. You don't need anything more than that for a cruiser. And this is what this is, a cruiser. So let's go for a joyride.
Everyone who sees the Fury starts smiling. But Nick has an extra reason to feel good about this car.
I love this car. I used to own this car 18 years ago. I sold it to a friend of mine back then, and now he sold it to someone else, and he's still my customer now, and he gave it to me to take it for a ride today after I have replaced his fuel pump. So you know what? He gave me permission to take it for a drive, I will. Why not? It is a beautiful day. It is a convertible. Why not? Let's go. Is that the suspension floats. No matter how rough the road is, or cracks, or speed bumps, or potholes, these cars, they just slide over. It's not like my wife's Mercedes-Benz that you feel every crack in the road. But this one here, this is like riding on the ocean or in a ship liner. So smooth. Look at that. It's just beautiful. Of course, it's a great day. This is beautiful. Imagine that, I've owned it 18 years ago. I never realized how many years have passed so fast. And here I am, 18 years later, and I see the car again. Or else, it is a Mopar. You know, don't come back to me for any repairs in many cases. And here it is. It came in for a fuel pump. We had to replace, and now we're driving it. Let's see how it goes. You know, if you ever think of going into a parade, this is one car to pick. You can put six people in here, whatever that is, six guys in here, and take a cruise in a parade. And what more can you ask for? This is a real show winner. 1970 Plymouth Fury. And you know what? It rides beautiful, it's a smooth ride. I'm gonna let my customer down. He enjoys the ride, he drives it often, let me tell you. On a beautiful day like this, why not? What better than a convertible to drive on a summer day? And now that summer's here, it's the way to go. So we gotta head back into the shop right now because I've got quite a few cars. And we have to do a lot of catching up to do. We gotta finish one car at a time, as fast as we can. But then again, I don't like rushing my jobs. I'll do what I can and do the best I can and take it from there. Let's head back into the shop and finish off the rest of the cars. I'll leave it here for now so my client can pick it up. And of course, my famous touch. This is one beautiful ride.
Inside the shop, Vasily is pulling the big heads off Al's Hemi.
They're not light, eh?
No.
These cats aren't Hemi heads, they're so heavy. There we go.
Alain likes to push his car, and he's noticed some pinging, so they're going to drop the cylinder pressure a little by swapping out the 20 thou gaskets for 60 thou. The Mad Max Interceptor project is almost ready. The 351 Cleveland is back in after dyno testing. But right now, Nick needs to move the car and make some space.
I need the lift to pick up another car, so in the meantime, I'm just gonna move it outside temporarily. So let's see, we're gonna move the car for the first time after we did the engine. Put on our fake blower and just drive it out of the building, see how it goes.
Still needs a few finishing touches, and a new double pumper carb will be installed before it's time to close the hood on this one. But how cool is it to see the Interceptor rolling under its own power?
This is gonna be strange, eh? Driving a car with the blower coming out of the hood. When I get the hood back on, that is.
Chris and Nick have brought this project to near perfection. But there are other cars that have a long way to go. This Challenger looks like it was probably painted with a brush about 20 years back. And it has bathroom carpets on the floor pans. But it's still a Dodge Challenger. It still has a pistol grip shifter, and it's still cool. And while we're talking about time machine cars, get ready to go way back with this Disco Firebird that a new client of Nick's just picked up.
You wanna see something genuine? Check this out. 1970, 1980s era, right here. We're gonna remove it now, but we're gonna leave it just for a day. This brake bring back some memories. I used to work for Pontiac from 1976 till 1981. And this vehicle is a 1978 Trans Am. And it sure brings back memories from the dealership where I used to work. I remember these cars when they used to come off the truck, off the loader, and I had to do the inspection before delivery. Boy, it sure brings back some memories.
Oh, what a long day charging.
I got my tire balance ain't working anymore. We gotta fix that. Gotta call a few customers, make some estimates. But some people call me up when I'm very busy and they ask me, Nick, how much did it cost to build a 500 horsepower, 440. Well, I have ballpark figures, but then again, if you want to go into details, that would be my night job. So call me after 6 Eastern Standard Time, and then we'll talk. Thank you.
Nick and his crew put in long, hard days, every day, so that the shop's clients can enjoy their cars worry-free. But for some clients, maintaining old vehicles means more than just a hot rod or a weekend cruiser. For gentlemen like Nick's last client of the day, keeping the old trucks working means keeping the family business open.
It's a Dodge Ram 250, 1988, with a 318 motor that has a hesitation every time he presses the gas. So you know what? We're going to put a new set of wires on the spark plugs and we'll take it from there. Here we go. Hey, this truck only has 17,000 kilometers. That's it. So I really don't think it has any mechanical problems, but I believe it's the wiring on the spark plugs. Well, we're gonna take a chance and change them and take it from there. This is a true blue working vehicle. It works 5 days a week, sometimes six days a week, but only in the summertime. Of course, he doesn't want to drive this in the winter because he wants to preserve it, but it's a beautiful truck. It's rust-free. And it's a full working vehicle, as you can see. He does asphalt, like it says on his door. Look at this. He carries all the equipment every day with it. And that trailer is always attached to this truck at all times. And this is one of his few vehicles that he has in his collection. He's got a lot more. He's into trucks, Fargo, Dodge, and a few Chrysler Plymouth cars that he has. I don't know how many he has, but he's got a little museum, or I should say a large museum back home, and I'm supposed to go visit it one day when I get a chance, which I will in the future. But in the meantime, I'll work on his first truck that he's brought me here, and then we'll take it from there.
Keeping the old iron running so that people can keep on rolling. That's what they do every day at Nick's Garage.